How many times now has Donald Trump denounced white supremacy, the Klan, and many of these groups specifically? I don't know, 80, 100, and I'm going to be completely honest with you. I don't even want to record this segment. And I actually thought to myself, you know what, maybe just for this month, I can go away and all these lefties who don't like me can be happy. But do we really need to hear over and over again the exact same things? The media is lying. Are we all just absolutely convinced of what we're going to be doing on election night and who we think is going to win? Have we all made up our minds already? And is this completely pointless? It feels like it. But I guess after reading how insane the fake news was, and seeing one story in particular, that Black Lives Matter, a local chapter, and a local Proud Boys chapter came together to denounce white supremacy, I thought it'd be really important to actually highlight this and ask a favor of all of you to share this video. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, but share this. And I think the sharing is the most important thing. Normally, I only say it on my main channel, but it does feel, I feel a bit defeated in that I can do these segments over and over again, showing you definitive proof that the mainstream media narrative is bunk, and people just don't hear it. And I don't know what else to do, right? I can say it over and over again, but it feels like preaching to the choir. Let me just jump in the news and show you some of these stories. And I'm going to once again definitively debunk these narratives about Trump and the Proud Boys. I'm tired of it. John Roberts lashes out at critics who ripped obnoxious presser behavior. Backlash grows. Now, this story's from just the other day. John Roberts was questioning Kayleigh McEnany. Is Trump going to denounce white supremacy? Because John Roberts is as dumb as a box of rocks, and he does not actually do a Google search. Now, I don't like being mean or disrespectful, but I got to tell you, I am at my wit's end with these people purporting to be journalists who don't bother doing a Google search. A Google search is the bare minimum you have to do when you're fact-checking something. And they don't do it. So now John Roberts is mad because people on Twitter actually did the Google search. And as it turns out, oh, I love this stuff. Jim Acosta says on Twitter, Trump has finally condemned white supremacists, .. on Hannity. Jim, you are such the worst of the worst in terms of manipulating your audience for clicks. I think Jim Acosta is, you know, to be fair, maybe he's not all that bad. Maybe he just has the memory of a goldfish. And so do the rest of these journalists. And I think that really might be it. The memory of a goldfish. 3 minutes. Is that the memory of a goldfish? I think it's something like that. They can't remember what they said yesterday. They can't remember what they said a year ago. And they can't remember anything from his administration. Jim Acosta. Trump has finally. Oh, thank goodness. And you know what I did? I Google searched white supremacists, Jim Acosta, and Twitter. And you can clearly see so did many other people. Because on August 14th, 2017, Jim Acosta himself tweeted, Trump condemns KKK and white supremacists commenting on Charlottesville. Racism is evil. Oh, 3 years ago, over 3 years ago. But these people, you know what it is? I'm sorry to say it, man. But you got a lot of people that just hate. They have nothing but hate inside their hearts. And that, and of course, there's racists that have nothing but hate in their hearts. But the left really has become a vile, vile, hate-filled rage machine. And I'm sorry to say it is the majority of the left. Typically, I like to say it's not all of them. It's not even most. I don't know. There's enough of them. No, this is different. This is the clear exploitation of the rage machine that these people on the left, okay, what? And listen, I'll tell you something. There's a really funny tweet by this woman. Her name is Joelle. I'm not going to say her last name because I don't want people dragging her. But she announced on Twitter that she lost a client over one of Donald Trump's executive orders on critical race theory because people can't work with critical race theory anymore. And she said there seems to be a cohort of people who are passionately opposed to critical race theory, who also hate Donald Trump. Surprise, surprise. The former liberals who now find them politically homeless, or many of whom still say they are liberal, but are not leftists. You see, the left has become, you know, it's like a rage monster. They thrive and feed on hate. So people like Jim Acosta are completely capable of saying something like in 2017, Trump denounces white supremacy. And then in 2020 to say Trump finally does it. Why? Because these people don't care about what's true. They just want to hate. The funny thing is, certainly Trump has members of his base who just hate. They hate the liberals. They want to own the liberals. They hate. But it's a tendency. As I often say, because when you look at social media, and I think credit goes to Twitter for banning the more fringe of the right, you see mostly moderate individuals who have moderate opinions and are rejecting the lies of the media. So for me, for instance, do I hate? No, I actually laugh a lot about things. I get angry sometimes. It's really funny. You know, I had Michael Malice. He's amazing. He's a hilarious guy. You should definitely check him out. I laugh at his tweets all the time. The dude's brilliant. And I had him on the IRL podcast, my nightly live show. And he saw me like goo goo gaga-ing my cat and like, you know, petting my cat or whatever. And he was like, wow, I'm glad that you're, you know, this is your demeanor, because people were worried that you were, you know, upset or black-pilled. And you know what I say, man? YouTube is going to show you certain content. So if you're watching only my videos on like riots and stuff or things like this, you're going to see me angry. But if you're watching, say, like the IRL podcast, you're going to see us laughing, making jokes, and you got to make sure that you get more than just one channel. Even if it's like, not, and I'm saying, you don't just watch me, you got to watch other people. But I don't like hating. I don't hate Jim Acosta, but I am really, I don't know what the right word is for it. I hate the idea. That's probably a better way to explain it. Me personally, I hate the machine. I hate the system. I hate the companies and the corporations. I care very little for the individuals who are cogs in that machine. Though I do think they need to be held responsible for the actions they take. I don't want to go around just hating on people. Of course, there are people I do hate. I don't hate Joe Biden. I don't hate Ocasio-Cortez. I don't hate Trump. I don't hate Pence. I don't hate most Republicans. I think Republicans, for the most part, are like do nothing and lazy. Rhinos, Republican in name only, and dinos, and our crony capitalist establishment, I very much despise, for sure. But anyway, to get back to the point, the left is thriving on it. And because they're thriving on it, you can have this narrative that never goes away. Trump is a white supremacist. Trump refuses to denounce white supremacy, no matter how many times he says it. No matter how many times Kayleigh McEnany denounces it. Here's what happened with John Roberts. They say, Fox News' chief White House correspondent wrote his first ever Jim Acosta-themed Dear Diary entry this Thursday, and it was a sight to behold. Roberts experienced his first Acosta-like meltdown after critics on social media blasted him for acting obnoxious during a White House briefing. During a briefing that afternoon, Roberts asked White House Press Secretary Kayleigh McEnany whether she can confirm that President Donald Trump denounces white supremacy. Well, and that's because John Roberts doesn't know how to use Google. Because he doesn't know how to use Google. These are the people who work for our media outlets. I don't blame people for being dumb. I will blame certain people like Jim Acosta. I think he is a snake oil salesman, as an easy way to put it. I think Donald Trump has similar characteristics in some regards, but not nearly as bad as the entire media apparatus. And even if your criticism of Trump is that he's a grifter and that he's manipulating people, sure, fine, but he's one guy. Sure, fine, he became president. I recognize the power of the presidency. But what do you have to say to CBS, NBC, ABC, CNN? I mean, the list of these mainstream outlets goes on. What do you have to say about the entire media apparatus doing the exact same thing? They say nothing. Well, now you get John Roberts. Here's what he said. The press secretary responded by listing multiple examples of the president having denounced white supremacy. Some of them this very week, but that wasn't enough for Roberts. Quote, but just to clear it up this morning, can you, naming it, make a declarative statement that the president denounces it? In response, McEnany said, I just did. This prompted Roberts to accuse her of having just read a bunch of quotes from the past. Is the argument now that at some point in the past few months, Trump went, you know what? I personally no longer want to denounce, you know, white supremacists. Or I'm going to change my mind, says Trump. No, it's just the stupidest thing ever. It's fake news. It's emotional manipulation. It is lazy. And here I am having to talk about it. So I'm going to move on for this. And I want to talk to you about what is actually going on. So Roberts snaps and he's like, you know, he goes on TV and he gets all angry and he's like, I had to ask this question. Okay. I had to ask it. Blah, blah, blah. I don't care, dude. You want to be Jim Acosta. You want to pander to the people who just hate? Go ahead and do it. Take a look at this story. Police arrest Proud Boy member on assault and gun charges hours after Trump refuses to denounce white supremacy. Okay, this guy that they're claiming is a Proud Boy member, what's his name? Alan Swinney. Did Chris Riota of The Independent Google search it? He didn't. Did he reach out to the Proud Boys for comment on this individual? He didn't. I'm sorry to say. Of course he didn't. And of course, that's the that's just how things go. From the post-millennial. Multiple media outlets falsely claim man arrested for assault during Portland riots is a Proud Boy. Alan Swinney is not a Proud Boy. And you know what? I think it's really funny. They tried to address this by saying, well, Alan Swinney may not actually be a Proud Boy. He was hanging out with Proud Boys. And what? So what? Get your facts straight. They don't want to. They want a narrative. Andy No says, I reached out to the organization and they say he's not a member. Interesting. Andy No says this is the only arrest in Portland that Ted Wheeler has brought attention to this year. And according to the Proud Boys, Swinney is not and has never been a member. Enrique Tarrio, chair of the Proud Boys, tells me Swinney is not and has never been a member of the organization through any of the chapters. I'm just tired of it, man. Now, I know many of you probably didn't see these things. And I know many people probably rely on me to bring these pieces together and to give you proper context. Some people on the left like to say, Tim Pool's not really a journalist. Some people even on the right say, well, Tim Pool's a good news aggregator. And it's because nobody has any idea what I actually have to do behind the scenes before I even run these stories. It's called journalism. It's called collecting and disseminating information. And it's called fact checking and verifying. I watch videos. I do all the work. But you know, people, they just assume that this guy, check this out. Here's the point. It's really frustrating. This guy, Chris Riota, he's with The Independent. He literally did no work. Okay, figuratively. He didn't even fact check any of these statements. And that's supposed to be journalism. But me fact checking all of these people, I guess, is not. So the point is, not that I care what anybody really thinks. The point is, our news media in this country is complete trash. As exemplified by Jim Acosta forgetting his own tweets. It's just a stupid waste of time. And so I'm going to be completely honest, man. It's you know, 15 or so minutes before I'm going to record this. I'm sitting here like, why am I going to talk about this? Why am I going to say the same thing again? You all know the media is lying. Are we preaching to the choir? Is that what I'm doing? Now, I get it. A lot of you who are watching probably didn't know many of these things. And that's why I decided, no, I have to point this out, that the manipulation runs deep. I have to do it. Even if I'm tired of saying it, because I got to tell you, I am. Especially the story in the Proud Boys. Come on, man. This was, what, 3 or 4 days ago. And now there's an entirely news cycle where the left is like gloating and laughing and praying for death because Donald Trump got sick. This is disgusting, man. I'm so sick of the hate and the evil. You know, when Ruth Bader Ginsburg died and a bunch of Trump supporters started dancing on her grave, I'm just so sick of it. Man, knock it off. I don't blame Trump for the grave dancing. I don't blame Trump for the rhetoric. I don't blame Trump for the demeanor. A lot of people say, well, Trump's making things worse or Trump's normalizing it. No, dude, you had no idea what was going on in this country. You weren't paying attention. And many of these progressives voted for Barack Obama, who fanned the flames of a lot of this stuff. It didn't just appear out of nowhere. Simply because you are now starting to listen to the news doesn't mean it was just created under Trump. The grave dancing had been a long time coming, and it's sick. I don't like it when the left is saying about Trump, and I don't like it when the right is saying about Ruth Bader Ginsburg or anybody else. I was extremely offended by the things they were saying about Herman Cain. That dude was awesome. I just watched a documentary with him in it. Dude was awesome. I don't know a lot about his political beliefs as a politician, for sure, but I know that as an individual, the way he carried himself, the stories he told, and a lot of the things he was saying in this documentary about his hard work was inspirational. And that's why I'm saying he was a rad dude. And so people danced on his grave, and I'm just so sick of the hate. But you know what? The right has a major benefit in this, because the right certainly has their hate mongers. But you see, social media bans them, and they're gone. You go on Twitter, you say these nasty things, people will ban you. And the right is more than willing to get rid of their extremists. Left isn't. The left gloats and wallows in the filth. And then I have to read it, and it's in all of our mainstream news institutions. I mean, NBC has this one guy who is like one of the most insane conspiracy, like they dress up their conspiracy psychosis with this veneer of real journalism. And you and I read it and I'm just like, you know what, man? The way I describe it is it's like I feel like I'm trying to knock down a skyscraper and I have nothing but a little ball peen hammer. I'm just like ding, ting, ting, banging away and it's not working. And a lot of people are watching and they're like, you go, Tim, you hit that skyscraper with that hammer. And they're internally grateful that I'm trying my hardest to break down and reject the fake news and fact check it. But you get all these news organizations that are just building away as the tower to reaches the sky. And I can't stop it on my own. And there are even people on YouTube who perpetuate in many, many lies. So it feels like no matter how much I push against this stupid BS, the cyclone is getting worse. You can't stop the tidal wave, man. So maybe I'm just, one of the last few people trying to figure out where that truth lies. Of course, there are many people who are going to claim that they're the ones doing it too, but it's frustrating. I bring you now to this story from KUTV. Black Lives Matter group, Proud Boys, stand together at Salt Lake City press conference. They say a Salt Lake chapter of the Proud Boys gathered at Washington Square Wednesday night to try and change the narrative that they're racist. Quote, I don't care what color your skin is. We're all Americans, and we need to find a way to come together instead of divide, said the local Proud Boys president, a man named Seth, who declined to offer his last name. In a line seemingly at odds with an organization the Southern Poverty Law Center and the ADL says is a hate group, we are in no way, shape, or form white supremacists, said Thad, the group's chief, who also declined to provide his last name. Enrique Tarrio, for instance, is Afro-Cuban. So I believe, he's black and Latino. That's how he's been described. He's not a white guy. And he actually said that white supremacists should be labeled, terrorists, that they're, and they reject it in every form. On their website, they talk about what they support. They support free speech, meritocracy, Western values, venerating the housewife, things like that. It's a fraternity. It's like a men's club. They have endorsed violence in the past. Part of their degrees, ranking, was based on getting into a fight in defense of Western values. That's wrong. I don't think they should be doing that. I think they should be trying to push back. But it's crazy to me that you can have the Southern Poverty Law Center and the ADL say that the Proud Boys are white supremacists when they're literally saying they're non-white members who are running these chapters, or Enrique Tarrio, who's like the legit chair of the entire organization, are not even white. Yet we still get fake news about all of this. And here is my favorite takeaway. While Jim Acosta finally says that Donald Trump denounces white supremacy. I'm kidding, by the way. He said it before. Here's the new narrative. Trump may denounce white supremacists, but he is never angry. There's no winning. There's no winning. It is entirely frustrating every single day. But I'll tell you this. I am not pessimistic in a sense. When I'm frustrated that it is an uphill battle and it feels like there's no way to win, I don't care what it feels like. And this is an important life lesson for everybody. I don't care what you think may be holding you back. You must persevere. And that's the point I'm bringing up. As I look at this video and just am sick and tired of talking about this and all the stupid BS, I still did the segment. And that was the important takeaway. I'm not going to sit here and think that what I do is not working, or, even if it feels like I'm fighting against this fake news, I am getting a ridiculous amount of traffic to my content. 100 million, 120 million or something in the past month is insane between all my channels. And so people are listening. And even though CNN, MSNBC, ABC, CBS, and whatever get substantially more, it's still significant. And so that's why I say I should probably ask people to share these videos more often so that people can actually hear and see the breakdown. You can disagree with my opinions, absolutely. But if you want to deny that the Proud Boys are rejecting white supremacy, well, then you are making assumptions about what their intention is. I'm not going to do that. I can only tell you what they said. Southern Poverty Law Center says they're a white supremacist group or a hate group or whatever. They say, no, we reject all of that. Make up your own mind, I guess. In my personal opinion, they're not white supremacists. Why? Their leaders are not white, and they said straight up they reject it. So I don't know what else you expect to get from that. They also have, gay members and, they have gay, straight, very different religions. I think I once met a Muslim Proud Boy, and they were talking about it, and they said, all that matters is Western values. They don't care what your religion is. But of course, You know, there are going to be people in the Proud Boys who have crummy opinions, you know, and they're going to get called out for it. And they're going to use that to go against the entirety of the Proud Boys. There was a tweet from, I believe it was an NBC journalist I tweeted, saying that, oh, Antifa, their horrifying ideology, linking to a story where it claimed like Antifa, you know, they want mutual aid and they want to provide people with resources and food and all that stuff. And I tweeted, an avowed Antifa member shot and killed a Trump supporter in Portland, hunted him down. An avowed Antifa member went to an ICE facility with firebombs and started shooting at law enforcement. We have had 127 days of avowed Antifa rioting. I should be clarify, though, not every single night was an Antifa riot. A lot of Black Lives Matter. Some of it was just general unrest, but we did have many, many riots. So for the past 127 days, there has been sporadic, but almost every day, some kind of violent unrest or riots coming from identified Antifa. We don't get that with the Proud Boys. So you can criticize individual Proud Boys for their wrongdoing, but when Antifa does this and it's sustained, and our media apparatus in this country supports them and defends them while claiming Trump won't denounce white supremacy, I just get sick and tired of it. So that's why I said share this video and share as many as you can, I guess, because I think the only way we actually defeat the establishment lies is if you are all willing to share videos like this. I guess ultimately the problem comes down to many people are probably going to share who they think is right, as they should. But then they end up sharing people who are wrong. And that's probably me as well in a lot of circumstances. So I think ultimately what we can do is, it doesn't matter who you're sharing in terms of social media, just stop sharing mainstream media. Start looking for independent voices so that at least we can have a real conversation. Because the establishment is bunk and these stories are ridiculous. Like Trump, he did denounce them, but he's not mad. He's not, okay, whatever, man. So I'll leave it there. Today's a stupid day. You know, part of my frustration comes from every single article now is, you know, about Trump and COVID. And many of these high profile verified blue check leftists are laughing and gloating. And I'm just so sick of the hatred. Chill, man. I think Biden's a lot of things. I don't like him. Don't want to vote for him. I don't hate Biden. I wish him well. I hope he stays safe. I hope he doesn't get COVID or anything like that. And I hope, as I've said, it's kind of horrible to see him in this position. I'm going to try and do better as I always do and make sure the hate is kept to a minimum. And I hope the left does the same and the right, too. I'll leave it there. Next segment's coming up at 4 p.m. over at youtube.com/Timcast. It is a different channel from this one. It's my main channel. Thanks for hanging out, and I will see you all then.